Straight to the deepest secrets of different bills. Hey, don't put them in, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Went from defenders to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm is coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drag my name in dirt. They try to bring me down, see me winning, you ain't like me.
Yo, what's good, my nephews and nieces? This is your favorite uncle, Uncle Demi, and today I have another special banger for you. All right, now listen, before we get too far in this video, you know exactly what you need to do. Make sure you drop a like, and let's get this video to at least 1,000 likes. That would definitely push the video to the recommended. And furthermore, if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe. I'm by far the hardest working YouTuber in the 2K community, and hope you can appreciate the 9 a.m. and the 5 p.m. daily double uploads. You can show that appreciation by dropping a like and subscribing, all right? Now, let's get straight into this video. So today, my nephews and nieces, we are kicking off, obviously, Season 2 Meta Build Series. And this season, when it comes to the guards, there has been a slight change to the guard play from Season 1 to Season 2. As we know in Season 1, there was just a lot of factors that we didn't know about until after the fact. So a lot of the guards in Season 1 were 6'5". Some were lucky enough to be 6'4", but obviously, you know, it came to fruition that, yo, you want to be 6'4 and shorter with an 85 ball handle, okay? So that's really what started to change the shift of how guards were being made. At the end of Season 1, going to Season 2, guards became shorter. Well, then it was again, you know, in next gen, there was this whole wave of making 5'10s, right? So again, it still trickled back into current gen. So now what we're seeing is a lot of extremely small, extremely fast point guards, right? So you want to go shooting guard in this instance, but you could go point guard. But believe it or not, you get better attributes going shooting guard, and you also get rim protect, okay? Now, we do want to go at the Hall of Fame shooting, Hall of Fame playmaking. That never changes. I mean, pretty much every guard's going to be this way. You want to go pure speed. And then what you want to do here is you want to go 76 on your driving layup, and then max out your driving dunk, right? Then you want to max out your mid-range, your three-point shot, your free throw, post fade, all that. And then go 89 on your free throw. And then you want to max out your pass accuracy, your ball handling, and your post control, right? That give you 23. Actually, yeah, let's go 87 on the pass accuracy. That'll keep that 23. Then we'll max out the perimeter defense, the lateral quickness, the steals, the defensive rebound, and then that block. So what you're looking at is 125, 23, 7. So there's a lot of things that has changed. Remember, most play shots season one, and second set, some people still roll that, but you see a lot of play shots this time around. They're more primarily focused on being able to get as many shooting badges as possible. Circus threes has now been 100% patched. So now, buffed. So people are doing fadeaways in the corner. They're doing crazy, you know, shots. It's just, it's a lot different. The game's a lot different. You have a lot of playmaking, and as usual, no one's really caring about the finishing because you're just going to get quick drops off one and long athletic layup. And then defensively, you still get the 7 badges, okay? So body type, you do want to go built here, and now you want to go all the way down to 6'1". So I see a lot of 5'10s, 6 feet, and 6'1 builds right now, especially in the stage. You want to see a lot. And the wave is because what you're trying to do is we get that 99 speed, right? Now, being taller does not allow you to have that 99 speed, but coming here, you will be able to get that 99 speed. You do want to get your weight all the way to 165. And then your wingspan, believe it or not, you want to go ahead and bring it all the way down. So you could max your wingspan all the way out, which is perfectly fine. You can do that. It's perfectly fine. That's going to be more so for your defense, because you get an 80 perimeter defense, 80 lateral quickness, and an 88 steal. Trust me, that's all good and dandy. But we're talking about what the wave is. And the wave is trying to get that high three ball to be able to shoot ridiculous threes and just be able to be just the toxic left-righting guard that you want to be. Remember, we're trying to make the meta build that a lot of people are using. And I usually try to gauge that with the comp players. And I usually, like I said, I do play a lot of part, but I just like to see what the feeling is in the stage and what are the best builds that are coming through. And obviously, this is the wave right now, all right? So when you look at your physicals, you do know you get a plus 8 to your physicals. You get a plus 4 from 95, 99 overall. You get the other plus 4 by either doing the My Career route, get the gym rat badge that way, or you can go into the do the season in the park where you hit level 40 in season, or just go to the Gary facility every 4 days. 7 days and get a plus 4 on the workout. So you have that 99 speed and that 99 acceleration I was talking about. And then now you get the plus 4 on your left side. So what you're looking at here is an 80 driving layup, a 65 driving dunk. But then look at the shooting. You get a 98 mid-range and a 95 three-point shot. Now with that 98 mid-range, I also see people in the twos court just fading left and right in the mid-range and a three-point shot, doing crazy step backs. The build's really toxic when it comes to shooting. It's very, very hard to stop a build like this, especially when they have a solid center setting screens, okay? Then your pass accuracy is a 91. You have a 95 ball handle. And then defensively, he's still decent. At a 78 perimeter and lateral quickness and an 82 steal with T-Rex arms. Like, it's crazy to still have an 82 steal with T-Rex arms, all right? And then, of course, when you have your takeovers, obviously, you do want to go sharp take here. This is what the wave is. You want to go with that sharp take. And then here you have my nephews and nieces. We have the Season 2 Playmaking Shot Creator. Again, this might be the way for a few more seasons. Hopefully we can trickle out of this, but a lot of this depicts on how the updates are doing. And right now, with the way that the updates and the patches have gone, this is going to be the build we're working with. So now let's go ahead and test this build out real quick. We'll get a 99, and of course, we will get you out of here, okay? So we want to go ahead and max this out to 99. Here, you just probably want to go Fearless Finisher, or you can go Posterizer, but Fearless Finisher is the best one here for the layups. And then here, what you want to do is you want to get Blinders Hall of Fame. Of course, you want to get the Hot Zone Hunter Hall of Fame. You want to get Sniper, Stop and Pop. You want to get Mismatch Expert. And now people are using Circus 3s, okay? And then what I usually do is go Lucky 7 right here. So this is basically one of the ways that people go with this. Circus 3s, like I said, it is high difficult jumpers such as hop step, spin, step backs, and pull-ups receive a shot percentage boost from 3. And I'm telling you, that's what people do. And I know you played them. They're doing hop steps at 3s. They're running. They're doing a little standing fade, getting the greens. It's really toxic. And again, there's nothing you can really do about it right now. But this is what a lot of people rock with. They don't care about the green machine, rhythm shooter, volume shooter. But there's other people that go some gold badges. But this is, for the most part, what you're going to see with this build. And the playmaking side, obviously, the most important ones, we go on handles for days, quick first step. Tight handles is ridiculous. A lot of people go Unpluckable Gold or Hall of Fame. Hyperdrive on bronze. People get bullet. Now, me too, it's funny. I know some people that don't get bullet passer, but just on bronze and bell out on bronze, right? They go just like this, okay? Of course, you need quick chain. Again, a lot of the guards are putting so much emphasis on making sure they have what they need. And even then, some people even take hyperdrive and they don't even have hyperdrive at all. I disagree with that. I think you always want to have hyperdrive, but again, that's how some people rock. Some people go like this. There's really many ways to go about it, but this combination here with these four is very, very toxic. Tight handle stuns a lot of defenders. It's very annoying, especially when you stun them and then you go into the corner and fade for 3, right? And then defensively, obviously what we're going here is we're going with the Intimidator. We're going with the Pick Dodger, because that's what most times that's what happened, and then chase down, and then you kind of have the wave right there. But there you have, my nephews and nieces. This is the Season 2 Meta Guard build. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, just make sure you drop a like, you subscribe to the channel, and as usual, your favorite old head, Uncle Demi. I'll be back really, really soon with the banger, man. And you know, when I say I'm back soon with the banger, you know exactly what I'm talking about. I'm talking about tomorrow, man. I'm out.
If he call for a low, we gon' give it to him. Take the stop off the top of no transformer. Man, we're ducking and dodging on that corner. Doing flip with a beat like a mighty morpher. Told myself to get rich and go have